The silo is not only just another housing project. It is really a project which is speaking about the transformation of our cities from industrial cities to more livable cities. It's a post-industrial monument, it's big concrete corn silo, and many people didn't see any potentials in that building. But we had a very strong belief that we should keep the soul and the character of the silo, and we wanted to preserve the building as much but giving a new three-dimensional skin, like a really super cool jacket. And the jacket is out of hot galvanized steel, which is having a beautiful patinating characteristic, and it really reacts to its context, the weather, the reflections of the water. So it's a very adaptable facade. You have to imagine that all the elements you see are uniquely built and are adapting a building which is actually having a three-dimensional curve. And each level is having a unique height. And I think that really helped us to create fantastic housing topologies. We cut out 30 kilometers of concrete to make a lot of openings. And then we placed the windows on the outside. So when you stand on the inside, you have a frameless window. We have been very true to a set of rules about distinguishing the existing building from all the new elements we have added to the building. What I really love with the silo is it's not only a housing project. It is a building which is opening up towards the city and is inviting the city towards itself through the gallery space in the ground level, where you can get inside and actually see the old structure of the silo. And we have a floating glass box on top, which is a restaurant and a public terrace. This year, the silo received the Project of the Year A+Award, and we're very happy for that. We have to be even better in fighting for existing building structures. We want to guide ourselves to more sustainable cities. With good design, you can inhabit the resources already used by keeping it and creating a new value for the future.